Hey guys, it's Alexa again, and you are watching Taltanic. We all have secrets, so why would celebrities be any different? They hide things deep within themselves, as we all do, but sometimes their secrets are more accessible than our own, considering their public status. People are genuinely curious about their pasts and strive to find every transgression and noteworthy piece of information about them, and let's be honest, it's great for content production. Here are some of the things the famous tried to bury. Here are secrets celebrities don't want you to know. Number 12, Tim Allen. Some may already know about this, and some may not, but we feel like it's pretty worth mentioning because it's Tim Allen, come on. Did you know that in the late 1970s, Tim Allen, your favorite dad from Home Improvement and everybody's favorite Santa, was arrested for trying to smuggle cocaine? This was in 1978 in an airport, and he was caught with 1.43 pounds of the energy-inducing substance. He was sentenced to between 3 and 7 years because he rolled on other dealers, which helped him avoid a life sentence, and was paroled from Federal Correctional Institution Sandstone, which is located in Sandstone, Minnesota, after only 2 years and 4 months. Timmy really dodged a bullet and most definitely turned his life around after that. Number 11, Mr. Matthew Broderick. A lot of people knew this once upon a time, but sometimes people forget things from the past, especially things that their favorite celebrities did that aren't so spectacular. Back on August 5th, 1987, Broderick was driving in Northern Ireland in a rented BMW with his then-girlfriend and Ferris Bueller's Day Off co-star Jennifer Grey when the car he was driving veered into the oncoming lane and struck a Volvo head-on. Both the driver of the other vehicle and her passenger, who also happened to be her mother, were killed instantly. Broderick sustained a few semi-major injuries, but nothing near as severe as the occupants of the other car suffered, obviously. Broderick said he didn't remember the crash or what happened leading up to it. He couldn't remember the day at all, or so he said, and only remembers waking up in the hospital. He faced up to 5 years in prison for causing death by dangerous driving, but instead was charged with careless driving and was hit with a $175 fine. Number 10, Chris Brown. You had to know that we were gonna bring this one up, as it's not very much of a secret. Not at all, actually. But everyone seems to have just overlooked Chris's transgressions and continued to support him today. Remember when he beat Rihanna? Badly? He was driving when she discovered that he was talking to an ex and stayed on him about it. And Chris, annoyed by it, decided the best thing to do would be to hit her. After a while, she was left to scream and cry with no one coming to help her, although somebody did eventually call 911 from their home after hearing her scream. Number 9, Bill O'Reilly. This is both terrible and semi-comical at the same time due to the irony of the whole situation. Well, Mr. O'Reilly has faced a lot of legal trouble in his time, and as recently as October 2017 was paying out settlements to keep things covered up. He supposedly harassed his secretary for an extended period of time before she had enough and decided to fight back. She sued him, and he paid a large sum of money to keep everything hush-hush, although it didn't really seem to work, now did it, Bill? The comical part of this is that he's released books that walk people through how they should be living their lives, which is pretty hypocritical, right? He was ousted from Fox News, where he had found a really nice home for his show, The O'Reilly Factor. You do the crime, you do the, losing all of your support. If you're a celebrity, that is. Number 8, Christopher Lee. Who would have thought? Did you know that young Christopher Lee actually witnessed the last public guillotine execution in France when he was but a 17-year-old boy? Now, this isn't much of a secret that has anything to do with him, but it is interesting that the Lord of the Rings, Star Wars, and Count Dracula actor actually bore witness to the last brutal execution to happen in public. He was present as Eugene Weidman, a serial murderer, was beheaded outside of a prison called Saint-Pierre in Versailles, and we just have to wonder if Chris himself got wild with the rest of the crowd. Apparently, spectators exhibited hysterical behavior at the execution, and it is for that reason why all further public executions in the country were halted. They still executed people, don't get us wrong, but they did so behind closed doors. Ironic that the actor would go on to play Charles-Henri Sanson, a headsman in a TV drama based on the French Revolution. Number 7, Rebecca Gayhart. All right then, this semi-successful actress and model actually hit a kid with her car in 2001, and he passed the next day. The boy, 9-year-old Jorge Cruz Jr., was walking across a street in Los Angeles when Rebecca hit him. She later pleaded no contest to vehicular manslaughter on November 27, 2001, and was given a sentence of 3 years probation and suffered a 1-year suspended license. She was also ordered to do community service and pay a small fine, but she avoided jail time altogether. She did, however, settle a wrongful death lawsuit the boy's parents brought out of court. Number 6, Woody Harrelson. Did you know that Woody Harrelson's dad was a convicted hitman? That's right, Charles Harrelson was a figure in organized crime and eventually went down for the assassination of John H. Wood Jr., a federal judge. He also took out a couple of other people in his time, and some even believe that he may have had something to do with the assassination of President John F. Kennedy. When he was caught, he stated that he'd taken out the judge and said he got President Kennedy too, probably sparking the idea behind his possible involvement. He was sentenced to 2 life sentences and ended up passing in prison at ADX Florence in Florence, Colorado on March 15, 2007. Wow, pretty interesting considering Harrelson starred in Natural Born Killers, isn't it? Number 5, William S. Burroughs. If you aren't familiar with Mr. Burroughs, know that he was part of the Beat Generation of authors, kind of like the crazy uncle of the bunch. And he wrote some pretty fantastic works in his time, including his most famous work, Naked Lunch. But did you know that he was convicted of manslaughter after shooting and killing his second wife, Joan Vollmer, in 1951 during a William Tell game they played while they were drunk? They were in Mexico City, and Burroughs decided to pull out his pistol and play the game the couple had never practiced before, and it ended tragically. Vollmer willingly participated by placing a highball glass on her head, but William's shot was off and struck his wife, killing her almost instantly. He spent 13 days in a Mexican jail before his brother went to free him by bribing Mexican officials and lawyers to release him on bail while he awaited trial. Number 4, Coco Chanel. Now, this isn't proven for sure, but there are many that believe that Coco Chanel may have been up to a lot more than we even know about. Those people think that Chanel may or may not have been an agent for Hitler's swastika-wearing army. There are actually a lot of her actions that can be traced back that make her look quite guilty of being up to something, and she was romantically involved with a known spy named Baron Hans-Gunther von Dinklage. She also had her own name and an agent number, which seems like a little more than suspicious. It's thought she was used to communicate with Winston Churchill since she was already acquainted with him, and why would she work with or for the army, we don't know. But that would be quite the big secret, wouldn't it? Number 3, Jack Nicholson. This is kind of mind-blowing. Jack Nicholson lived nearly 40 years of his life before finding out that the person he believed to be his sister was actually his mother, and that his other sister was actually his aunt. He was born April 22, 1937, to a showgirl, June Frances Nicholson, who was only 18 at the time, and who convinced her parents to raise Jack as their own. They did so, and it wasn't until Time magazine delved into Jack's life and family that he learned of the family secret. The magazine had researchers who found the info and broke it to the actor, who stated that it didn't shake him all that much. He said that it was, quote-unquote, a pretty dramatic event, but it wasn't what I'd call traumatizing. I was pretty well psychologically formed. Sounds pretty crazy and traumatizing to us, but hey, we guess he was nearly 40. So he took it in stride and carried on like the Jack Nicholson we all know and love. Number 2, Jay-Z. This may sound kind of funny, but at the time, little Jay-Z thought for sure that his life was over and that he was going to jail. The thing is, it would have been entirely possible for that to happen given what exactly happened back then. So Jay-Z, at age 12, shot his brother in the shoulder for stealing one of his rings. Yeah, little man Sean Corey Carter pulled out a gun that he got at someone's house and shot his brother over some stolen jewelry. Luckily for him, his brother didn't press charges and Jay managed to avoid any serious time for his crime. He was also a gang member as a child and was shot at a bunch of times, but yet again, luck was on his side and he was never hit. Crazy. What would the world have been like if we'd seen him go to jail and not make it to where he is today? We don't even want to think about it. Number 1, Mark Wahlberg. This may or may not come as a surprise, but did you know that Mark Wahlberg was involved in some racially motivated assault back when he was a kid? Well, he was more of a teenager, but he still beat up some people and did some terrible things, which he doesn't attribute to any racial motivation, but the courts and his actions and words say otherwise. When he was 14, he was in court for throwing rocks at and chasing young African-American schoolchildren and yelling racial slurs. 2 years later, at 16, he was in a convenience store and tried stealing alcohol from someone while yelling racial slurs, and he ended up knocking the man out with a stick. He then ran outside and came across another man, Ho Trinh, whom he subsequently punched in the face. For years, it was reported that Wahlberg blinded the second man in one eye. However, the man was already blind in that eye before the attack. Whenever you feel bad about your terrible decisions, just remember, you're not alone. Even celebrities get into deep water sometimes, but all you can do is put your head down and push on. If this video taught you anything, why not give it a like? Comment below to tell us what you thought. And don't forget to subscribe for fantastic videos every day.